With the growing significance of the Southeast Asian region and the downward trend of the Eurozone countries, the U.S. now pivots to its old allies in the Pacific in the wake of the rise of China, with westernized belief that Southeast Asia has moved beyond its original rationale.
I think that it's very clear to everyone that power dynamics are changing in the Asia-Pacific region. I think that the United States is in the process of rebalancing some of its security posture, and the president has a very high profile, you know, statement about that. And I think that because the United States and Thailand have a long history of cooperation, I think that there is a lot of reserve of goodwill still, and I think that it's important that in this new American security reconfiguration that Thailand not be left behind, that there be a role for Thailand and the U.S.-Thailand alliance.
Thailand is one of the oldest friends of the United States in Asia, with 2013 marking the 180th anniversary of the relationship. But the modern alliance has been kept stagnant since Cold War era for several reasons. The U.S. first shifted its security priorities in Southeast Asia after the September 2011 attack and domestic political dynamics on both sides. Another interesting factor is the budding relations between Thailand and China, which has expanded from trade to construction to military. The Thai survey reports also made it apparent that as many as 75% of Thai students view China as a better partner for Thailand than the U.S., amid the notion that China has already become the other superpower and a longtime friend. On that note, veteran journalist Kawee Chongkit Thawon, who is familiar with regional affairs for over decades, suggested that for Thailand to revive alliances with foreign friends, it can no longer leave things half-baked.
Thailand must be clear in its foreign policy toward Thai-US alliance and at the same time make sure that Thai-China relation is healthy. Thailand can pursue a foreign policy like Australia. You know, close ally with the United States. You display commitment to be a good ally, period. And then, 1, 2, 3, we can do. And then the rest, you don't mess with us because we have our own trade when we talk to China.
Meanwhile, the U.S. fleet expansion in the Asia-Pacific is the latest obvious change in its military strategy in the maritime scope. And Thailand's Utapao base happens to be the pivotal connection into the Southeast Asian region. Skeptical view of the U.S. intention has been inevitable, as Utapao would make up the perfect equation to balance out the power domination with China. The so-called humanitarian hub at Utapao, branded by the U.S. as a multi-purpose facility, is somewhat risky of being upgraded to an armed base if the government does not exercise cautions and wise diplomatic approach.
Good. Also, this is an image that already been perceived that in this region that the U.S. will use the Utapao as the a military base. So that's why Thailand military, Thai military, propose the regional platform. So when we talk about platform, it's been some many of collaboration can be done, not only in Utapao, but in any other places, so that the image, also the contents, could be broadened in terms of cooperation, not only the military, but also for the other agencies.
In a nutshell, it is up to the Thai government to make sure that no boundaries set will be stepped over and no advantages taken for personal interests, to eliminate fears that the humanitarian assistance objective would turn out to be the smoke above the water.
And this may be just tip of the iceberg between the power play between the superpowers, the U.S. and China. And Thailand needs to make a clear stance on where it stands, as the action speaks more than 1,000 words written in any agreements. Jurui Gitisin, reporting for ASEAN TV.